Ross, you are needed at the Jettribe paddock. For those of you who are not familiar, these are custom aftermarket holes made with carbon fiber and footholds so they can do these aerial maneuvers. Not to mention a little billet power plant underneath the hood. Will Rich and Brian Bowell please report to the Jettribe paddock? You are needed for scoring. Taking the water is Hassan Abudawood, coming to us from San Diego, California. Hassan rides for Richter RRP, Hot Products, Brap Doctor, and DASA. All right, folks, his first trick will start 2 minutes on the clock. 15 seconds to the end. We'll give him a blast of the horn. Big backflip. 180 into a backflip out of nothing. Riding it out. Give it up for him, folks. Big underflip away from the beach. Another backflip, and again, three-trick combo. Now, some of the criteria we go off of are trick count, difficulty. Oh, looks like Hassan's calling it right there, having some mechanical failure issues. Give it up for him, folks. Our amateur freestyle competitor having some mechanical difficulties. Trying to see if he can figure it all out. All right, moving to pro freestyle. Looks like Hassan's not going to be able to light that puppy up. We have Brad Roche coming to us from Peoria, Arizona, writing for Run What You Brung and Epic Industries. I'm corrected, Brad Roche. Taking the water, Brad Roche. Again, the first trick will start 2 minutes on the clock. When he approaches 15 seconds to the end of his routine, we'll blow the horn once, and at the end of the routine, twice. Getting himself a nice little setup wake there. Big 360 into a backflip. Almost riding it out, a little Hollywood tail stand there. Come on, folks, let's get pumped for them. Get loud. The louder you get, the bigger they go. Oh. Couple 180s there. Big backflip, a little off access, trying to nose stab and ride it out. One minute remaining in his routine. Oh, not quite making it that time. Let's see if he can get the boat flipped back over. Keep the water out of the engine. See if he can squeeze a couple more tricks in here before the clock runs out. Again, 15 seconds left on the clock. Probably be able to get a couple tricks in. 360. Oh, not riding it out. All right, that is the end of Brad's routine. Give him a round of applause, folks. All right, coming to us from Ketchikan, Alaska, it is Tanner the Tan Man Thomas. He's going to take the water for us, folks. Getting his feet kicked into those holds. Let's see if he's going to go big for us right off the bat. He's looking for a little courtesy. Let's give him a round of applause, folks. Oh, heading towards shore. Big 360. 180 into a backflip and another. How many do you think he's got, folks? Riding it out. Give it up for Tanner Thomas. Giving us a string of backflips there. Riding it out. Big 360. Another backflip. Clean landing. Big 360, backflip, little nose stab action, riding it out. 1 minute left in Tanner's routine. Ooh, is he going to give us a buoy flip? Not quite making it. Going for it again, over the checkered buoy. Big 360, backflip. Getting close to the 15 seconds left mark. One-hander backflip. Seconds left on the clock for our final pro competitor. Big one-handed 360 towards shore. And another low altitude into a backflip, riding it out. Give it up for Tanner the Tan Man. All right, let's give our judges a second to collaborate and get their minds together. All right, folks. All right, folks. The results are in. Our amateur competitor, Hassan Abudawood, coming in first. In our pro class, coming in second, Brad Roche. And first, Tanner the Tan Man. Annie Sims, you are needed. Annie Sims, you are needed. Please see Ross Wallach. At the Jettribe paddock. Hassan Abudawood giving you guys a free show on Tanner Thomas's Richter. All right, folks, looks like we're getting ready to resume racing. I'm going to hand off the mic back to your MC, Brian Bowell. All right, so a couple minutes here of some more freestyle going on. Hassan putting on a show for the crowd, but we're going to need the next race to the line soon. That's going to be the Novice Ski Stock, Moto 1. So everybody that transferred from the qualifiers, that's going to be Novice Ski Stock. So Novice Ski Stock, we're going to need you guys to the line right now. And we need all of our water staff to report back to the water. We're going to get things rolling. All of our water staff, please, back to the water. And race number 21, which is Moto 1 of Novice Ski Stock, should be to the line, please. We need all the RPM water staff, please report down to the water. All the RPM water staff, please report to the water. Let's get going. Race number 21, Novice Ski Stock to the line, Moto 1.
Okay, we got our race 22 lined up on the line. That's going to be Moto 1 of Novice Ski Stock. Looks like we're just waiting on our scoring staff so we can have all of our scoring staff report back to the tower, please. We can get rolling here. Everybody's on the line, ready to go. right, finally getting ready to get things rolling again. This is race 22, Moto 1, novice ski stock. Two cards in the air. We got a full line. Had qualifiers to get this far. So this will be Moto 1. It's like a clean start. Looks like it might be one of the Disneys with the lead here. The whole shot, the two Disney boys have to see as they come around. Indeed it is. The 99 of Disney taking the lead with his brother following close behind in second, the 27 Disney. The 123 coming across in third with the 57 Christopher Steenbach in fourth, Charles Anderson in fifth. So that'll round out your top five in lap number one. So Brent Disney, your early leader, followed by his brother, Kyle Disney. Third place, Tim Shanklin. We got a rider down on the split. So the rider down in the split was our leader, Disney. So the other Disney, which would be Kyle Disney, inherits the lead. So that's going to put Tim Shanklin in second, Christopher Steenbach into third. Our new fourth place is Charles Anderson. So Anderson going to come across fourth. The 24 marker right now is running fifth. So Disney from first to sixth after going down in the split section. Tough break for Brett Disney. So on the line next, we need race number one, Vintage 550s. Vintage 550, race number one to the line. Race two, Junior Ski 1315 lights to staging. Race two, Junior 1315 ski lights to staging. Race number one, Vintage 550 ski, you should be on the line now. Also, just a reminder, riders, in some of these classes that are Moto 2s for the overalls for the day, top three riders need to go to the tech tent, which is the blue tent behind the starting line. We need to check the boats. So after the Moto 2 finish, if you're in the top three, we need you to report to the blue tech tent. We are going to be checking the boats today in a lot of classes. So if you're in the top three and you want to keep your finishing position, you need to report to the tech tent after your race. Halfway flags are out right now for Disney, encountering a little bit of lap traffic, but still locking down the lead with the 123 of Tim Shanklin still running second. The 57 of Christopher Steenbach still holding down third. Charles Anderson holding down that fourth spot. And Brett Disney rounding out the top five after leading early. right, white flags in the air for the number 27, Disney. So Disney continues to lead, making his way around the right-hand side of the track. One more lap to go. The 57 of Christopher Steenbach was actually able to make a move into second with Charles Anderson third because the 123 of Tim Shanklin momentarily went down, so that's going to put him back to fourth. Kyle Disney still fifth. And your winner, Moto One, Novice Ski Stock. Disney coming across, taking the checkered flag as we wait for our second place rider to come around. That should be the 57 of Christopher Steenbach. So Steenbach taking that second position, Charles Anderson in third. Looks like Disney sneaking by Shanklin for fourth. That's going to put Shanklin down to fifth. So that is your top five Moto One Novice Stock. On the line now, race number one, starting over our second half of the day. Moto Two for the overalls. Vintage 550 Ski. On the number two out of Fallbrook, California, we've got Wyland Reed in. On the number 12 out of Chino, California, Jason Rivera. On the number 604 out of Lake Havasu City, Jason Tebutt. On the 621 out of Colorado Springs, Becky Cooper Powell. On the 909 out of Temecula, California, Colin Renner. And on the 911, Corey Van Cleve out of Lake Havasu City, Arizona. Right, taking the early lead in this Vintage 550 Ski, once again, the little pocket rocket, Wyland Reedin. He's got Jason Rivera in tow in second, and Corey Van Cleve in third. Van Cleve was trying to make a move. He had second locked up on the hole shot, had a big slide out, so that cost him. So now your top three, Wyland Reedin, Jason Rivera, and Corey Van Cleve in this Vintage 550 Ski. On the line next, race number two, Junior Ski, 1315 Lights. On the line next, Juniors, 1315 Ski Lights, race number two. Race number three, Sport GP. Race number three, Sport GP, you're on deck. Thank you. All right, halfway flags are out for Wyland Reed, and Little Pocket Rocket continues the lead, still with Jason Rivera in second. Corey Van Cleve still holding down that third position, so no change in the top three as they've separated themselves from the rest of the pack in this finish 550 ski. Coming up next is going to be Junior Ski 1315 Lights on the number 4 out of Peoria, Arizona is going to be Braden Wickland. On the number 12 out of Lake Havasu City, Theo Bomer. On the number 18 out of Bakersfield, Reese Maricich. On the number 27 out of Washington, Utah, going to be Kyle Disney. On the number 202 out of Lake Havasu City, Cole Kramer. On the number 242 out of Lake Havasu City, Preston Matzdorf. And on the number 418 out of Thousand Oaks, California, Tyler Shinko. That will be Junior Ski 1315 Lights, race number 2 coming up next. Taking the checkered flag, Moto 2, Vintage 550 Ski, the Pocket Rocket, Wyland Reedin. Battle rages on for second. Jason Rivera still holding off. A hard charging Corey Van Cleve. Van Cleve going down momentarily, so if Rivera can make it one more turn around, he'll lock down second, which he does. So taking second overall, looks like it's going to be Jason Rivera. And coming across in third, going to be Corey Van Cleve. Race number 2 on the line, Junior Ski, 1315 Lights, Moto 2. Top 3 report to Tech after the race. Top 3 to Tech after the race of Junior Ski, 1315 Lights. we're getting them locked up, ready to go. Race number two, junior ski, 13-15 lights, two card is in the air. Clean and green start. Looks like the 12, Theo Bomer, going to take the whole shot, early lead right now, coming around the outside split. Looks like it's going to be Cole Kramer heading to the inside. Preston Matzdorf in second on the outside, so the battle's on for the lead as Kramer takes the inside, not quite having enough just yet to track down Valmer. So it's going to be Valmer, Cole Kramer, and the 242 of Preston Matzdorf rounding out your top three. Come around in fourth, Braden Wickland. Fifth place, Reese Maricich with a battle right now with Tyler Shinko. Maricich temporarily going down, Shinko trying to make a move. Can't quite get a drive out of the turn, so as they run right now, that will be your top four. This time, Bomer went to the inside, Kramer to the outside, so we're going to have a battle for the lead here. Not quite enough. We got a rider down on the right-hand side of the track. Rider down on the right-hand side of the track. Looks like that's Disney. 27, Kyle Disney down in the water on the right-hand side of the track. So tough break for him. So the 12 of Theo Bomer continues to lead with Cole Kramer in hot pursuit. Preston Matzdorf running third, starting to pull away just a little bit from fourth place, Braden Wickland, who's now opened up his lead on fifth, the new fifth place rider of Reese Maricich. Looks like the course marshals attended to Disney. Kyle Disney up and running again, so tough break for him in this moto. But he's up and moving. It's a good sign. This time on the left-hand side of the track in the split course, Kramer decided to follow Bomer. Closed the gap just a little bit, starting to put the pressure on as the halfway flags are coming out. So if he, we'll see if Kramer can force a mistake. Trying to put the pressure on. Baumer sweeping that turn, keeping his buoys tight, not giving an inch. Doing everything he can to hold off Kramer. Matzdorf in hot pursuit, so the top three still opening up just a little bit on your fourth place, Braden Wickland, who's now opened up his lead on your fifth place, Reese Maricich. Tyler Shingo coming by. So once again, Kramer decided to follow Bomer. Two more laps to go. We'll see if he can make up any ground. The 242 of Matzdorf chose the inside split that time. It enables him to slightly close the gap on Kramer, but the top two riders going for it here today. These are juniors, 13 to 15-year-olds. The future of our sport is looking strong, ladies and gentlemen. These riders are putting on a show. Looks like we're going to have a good battle going down the back. Kramer's able to get it hooked up and close the gap one more time on Bomer. So Theo is going to go to the outside. This time Kramer's going to go to the inside. See if he can make up some ground. As the white flag getting ready to fly, he does make up quite a bit of ground. He's within one boat length now. So Kramer closed the gap within one boat length on the final lap. We'll see if he can reel him in and force Bomer to make a mistake. Bomer's going to run into some lap traffic, so we'll see if the lap traffic gives way here. Baumer cleanly by. Opened up his lead just a little bit down the back that time on Kramer. So we'll see if Kramer's going to use the split one more time. Baumer chose the outside. Kramer to the inside. Kramer just catching an edge that turn, so I think he's going to come up just a little bit short as he slid out just a little bit, giving it everything he had. So great ride by these two juniors in the 13-15 lights class. The future of our sport's looking strong. Put your hands together for these great riders putting on a great ride out here today. Preston Matzdorf coming across third. Annie Sims, we need you to registration, please. Annie Sims to registration, please. Once again, top three boats, we need to see you in tech. Top three, need to see you in tech, please. Coming up next, race number three, Sport GP. On the number 10 out of Chino, California, Tony Martinez. On the number 110 out of Redding, California, Denny Janeway. On the 169 out of Diamond Bar, California, Sean Cremata. And that'll round out our Sport GP class. Oh, there he is. Ross.
So on the water right now, finishing up race number three, Sport GP. Is this our leader? This is three. Right there, 10. On the line right now should be Vetsky Mod. Vetsky Mod, let's go. Jerry Wong. Adam Abadie, Jamie Perney, Tony Beck, Daniel Yonan, Charlie Rennie, Chris Haggis, David Fiquette, Jason Carlton, Mark Conroy, and Travis Green. to the line. Let's bring them to the line. Halfway through race number three, Sport GP. So your leader, Denny Janeway, out of Redding, California, Jet Dynamics, Watercraft Magic, followed by the 169 of Sean K. Mata, out of Diamond Bar, California, and the number 10, Tony Zoto Martinez. Let's finish giving you the order for race number four. On the pole, Jerry Wong. In the second spot, Adam Abadi from Upland, California on the 13. Jamie Perney out of Tracy, California in the third spot. Tony Beck out of Lake Havasu City, California in the fourth spot. Daniel Yonan in the fifth spot. Charlie Rennie in the sixth spot. Chris Hagest out of Lake Havasu City on Pro Watercraft Racing in the seventh spot. David Fiquette also from Lake Havasu City in the eighth spot. Jason Carlton in the ninth spot. 10th is Mark Conroy, and 11th is Travis Green. One lap to go. White flag flies. Denny Janeway, Redding, California, your leader. Sean K. Mata, then Tony Zoto Martinez. As they come around.
Did you hear that order? Chris? Seven. Yep. Jerry Wong is one. Hold on. I was reading off the announcer sheet. You're good. Never mind.
The giant hole shot, Chris Hagest, ProWatercraftRacing.com, out there in the front spot. Coming around, banging a little buoys. Let's see how they come across. Oh, we got somebody going down. So, Chris comes across the line in first. The 45 of Daniel Yonan, Jerry Wong, then the 31. The 525, the 245, Mark Conroy, Jason Carlton, the 815, or the 615 of Travis Green. Six laps. All right, this is race number four. Coming up, race number five. Hint, hint, Paul Pistone. Hint, hint, Paul Pistone. Race number five to the line. Race number five. Let's get him to the line right now. That's Vintage X2 Stock. I need John Lee, Summer Stout, James Gagnon, Derek Stout, Charles Sims, Matt Goldberg, and Jason Rivera. Correction, Jason Rivera is going to sleep. He's a little tuckered out. Not enough exercise prior to this race. More CrossFit for Jason Rivera. If he's going to do it at Paris.
Vintage X2 stock. We're going to go 4 and 3 7.
So once again, if I can get Vintage X2 Stock minus Jason Rivera, all the real X2 Stockers to come out. Jason's going to take a nap while X2 Stock's going to run. He's a little tired. Jason, tell me, are you a little tired?
Very tired.
Is it really rough out there?
Very.
Did you not sleep good last night?
Nope.
All right, see? There's the reason why. Jason was up partying all night. He's good now. He's going to take a little nappy, come back later and race with us. But I need John Lee, Summer Stout, James Gagnon, Derek Stout, Charlie Sims, and Matt Goldberg paging you people to the line right now. Let's go, Vintage X2. You're up next. Let's go, Vintage X2 Stock. But meanwhile, Daniel Yonan, Jerry Wong, the 31.
My announcer sheets are not good.
The 525 of Mark Conroy, Firebird Air Conditioning Commander Industries, Scat Track, followed by the 37 of Tony Beck, Lake Havasu City. David Prado on the 213. White flag coming out as the Vintage X2 Stockers are coming up. Derek Stout is here, ready to play. The 113, Matty Goldberg. The 109, stepfather Charlie Sims. The 24, Summer Stout out of San Marcos, California. The 36, James Gagnon. We're still looking for John Lee, Derek Stout. Never mind.
No, he cannot.
All right, Vintage X2 Stock on the line next. Race 6 is Novice Ski Stock Moto 2. You should be ready to go. Everybody from Moto 1 needs to be ready to go in Moto 2. That's race number 6. But on the water right now, checkered flag flies Chris Hagest, followed by the 13 of Adam Avedy, the 615 of Travis Green, the 245, Jason Carlton. Don't forget, if you're supposed to go to inspection, go to inspection. These are the second motos. These are your final motos of the day. What a battle, what a battle. 16 over the line before 45. Penny looks like got the position over Daniel Yonan. What a great battle to the end. The 525, Mark Conroy. The 31 coming across the line of Aaron Sanchez. And the 37, Tony Beck. But coming up right now, looks like my umbrella is not doing so good. Top three to inspection. Let's go. Top three to inspection.
So coming up next, race number five, Vintage X2 Stock. Vintage X2 Stock is on the line right now. On number 24 out of San Marcos, California, is going to be Summer Stout. On the number 36 out of Lake Havasu, James Gagnon. On the 100, also out of San Marcos, California, husband and wife team out there, Derek Stout. On the 109 out of Lake Elsinore, Charlie Sims. On the 113 out of Lake Elsinore, Matt Goldberg. And on the 151 out of Chino, California, is going to be Jason Rivera. Once again, in this class, Vintage X2 Stock, the top three overall finishers, please report to the blue tech tent right behind the starting line after you guys come around. We're going to need to see the top three boats to tech after this moto. Coming up next, race number six will be Moto 2 Novice Ski Stock. So race six on deck, Moto 2 Novice Ski Stock. All right, we've got these Vintage X2 Stock skis fired up on the line, ready to go. Chief starter Paul Pistone got the two card in the air. Ready to go here. All right, it's a clean and green start. Drag race into the first turn. We'll see who comes away with the hole shot. Coming across with a hole shot on the number 100, that's Derek Stout, your winner also from Moto 1. Looks like slipping into second, the 109 of Charlie Sims. Running third, the 113 of Matt Goldberg. It looks like. So a father son team out there running against each other right now. Dad beating the son. Age against youth and treachery here. Age and experience taking the lead. The X2 animal, Charlie Sims. So if we see if he has anything for Derek Stout, who's really turned up his game in the last couple races. Of course, all these guys from the Lake Elsinore, San Marcos area in Southern California riding together a lot. So good to see these guys out here tearing it up on these vintage X2s. So as they run right now in this Vintage X2 stock class, no change in the running order. Derek Stout continues to lead over Charlie Sims. The 113 of Matt Goldberg still holding down that third position. So the halfway flags are in the air. Three laps down, three more laps to go for Derek Stout. Top three started to separate themselves just a little bit from the rest of the pack. Over the fourth place, Summer Stout. So again, we got a father-son out there and a husband-wife mixing it up out there in Vintage X2 stock class. Also, can't forget the 36 ski of James Gagnon. So he's out there making his way around the left-hand side of the track now, coming through the split. Two more laps to go in this Vintage X2 stock. Looks like we've got our race six all lined up and ready to go, so thank you for cooperation. That's going to be Novice Stock, race six coming up next, which means race seven, going to be our Runabout Novice Limited, Runabout Women's, and Runabout Pro-Am Stock, and Runabout 800. You guys are on deck. So white flags are in the air one more time around for our three leaders. Derek Stout continuing to hold off Charlie Sims. As they encounter a little bit of lap traffic, Charlie Sims was starting to close the door, but he's having a little bit of trouble getting around the lap rider. So we'll see if Stout can turn up the wick going down the back straightaway and continue to hold off Sims. Now the battle's on for fourth as the 113 of Matt Goldberg had a slight bobble, and that's allowed Summer Stout to close the gap ever so slightly, so we'll see if she can make a charge on the last lap. And checkered flag in the air, your overall winner today in Vintage X2 stock. That's going to be Derek Stout taking the win with Charlie Sims coming across in second. And if he can stay upright for a few more turns, looks like the 113 of Matt Goldberg going to lock down third. All right, on the line next, race number six. Novice Ski Stock, we had to have qualifiers to set the field here today with a full starting gate. It's great to see the class just exploding in popularity. Novice Ski Stock, full gate here, getting ready to go for Moto 2. So he's going to take the overall here today in Novice Ski Stock. Got a lot of fast riders in this one with a full starting gate. Jonathan Mangan. Take a quick break here to let one of our course marshals, who's also racing, Jackson Rod, jump on his stock boat, get down to the starting line, so we'll get that situated here. And once again, we need the top three finishers of Vintage X2 stock report to the Blue Tech Tent.
right, now that we've got Jackson Rod on the line. Paul.
Pistone.
Sometime this century, Paul. All right, so race number 6 on the line. Race 7, you guys should be warming up. We got another red flag. That's what I saw. Fifty-five and 23. What? Ten will get called for jump. That's a one-lap penalty. There's no second restarts. So that's Mike Ribello. He'll be called for a one-lap penalty for jumping the start.
But coming around, the 27 of Kyle Disney, or the 27 of Kyle Disney, the 99 of Brent Disney, the 57 of Steenbach, Chris Steenbach, C57, then the boat number 20, Kyle Haas, then Mike Ribello. For race number 7, we need Novice Runabout Limited, Kelly Church. We need Women's Runabout, Leslie Nattaker Adams. We need Pro-Am Runabout Stock, Charlie Martinez. And then Amateur Runabout 800 Limited, Kevin Nitschke, Jason Rivera, and Jim Alamilo. Race 6 in the water, race 7 on the line right now. Race 8, you should be warming up. Race number 8, you should be warming motors as we're halfway through race number 6. Mike Ribello coming by, then the 24, the 113 of Keith Jax, the 901,
white flag coming out for the 99, Brent Disney, with the 27, Kyle Disney running a close second. All right, your winner, the 99, going to be Brent Disney with brother Kyle Disney coming across in second. So top three of the novice ski stock to the blue tech tent, please. All right, on the line right now, out on the racetrack, race number 7, we got the 4 different classes combined. So runabout novice limited, women's runabout pro-am stock, and runabout 800 limited. So our overall leader coming across first right now in the number 9 boat, that's Charlie Martinez coming across the line in second. But first in his class, that's the 7 of Kelly Church. Then we got a battle between the 800s between Kevin Nitschke and Jonathan Rivera right now. So we'll see how they shake it out on the 800s. And taking the lead in the women's class is Leslie Adams.
So Charlie Martinez out to an early lead, the definite delivery. But here's the battle for amateur runabout 800, side by side. That's what you want to see. As they come around, and then Leslie Nattaker Adams rounding out the field. So Charlie Martinez, Kelly Church. But the battle on the water is going to be between the 800s, as it looks like the 222 has now checked out. Or is it the 282? As Charlie Martinez comes around, but here comes Kelly Church. Oh, trying to renegotiate that turn. Swinging a little wide for even my comfort. Nedra, get out of the water right now, please. Nedra, get out of the water right now. 588 of Kevin Nitschke. The 33 of Leslie Nattaker Adams. Coming up next, race number 8. Blaster Speck, Ron Henderson, Chris Borsola, Randy Raidmaker, Hunter Dunn, Annie Sims, Tommy the Bomber Bonacci, and Dawn Fiquette. As Charlie Martinez makes another pass, Kelly Church coming around. Race number 7 on the water, combination of several classes.
Need a holder?
That's right. Brandy Raidmaker needs a holder. I need one holder. If somebody can help Brandy out for the next moto.
Anybody? Any of you fine, strong friends, fellows? We'll even take a fine female out there. Anybody? Somebody? Charlie Martin, Charlie Sims going out there to help. Thank you, Charlie.
Race number 7 on the water, Charlie Martinez coming by the score tower, followed closely by Kelly Church.
Race number 8 to the line right now. Race number 8, which is Blaster Spec, Tommy Bonacci, Hunter Dunn, Christopher Sola, Annie Sims, Brandy Raidmaker, David Fiquette, Ron Henderson. Let's get you to the line right now as we're coming up on the finish. As the 588 of Kevin Nitschke puts another lap in the books. Race number, as we're one lap away, white flag flies, Charlie Martinez, Kelly Church, Leslie Nattaker Adams.
So the bomber, with a great start, rockets off the beach. And that. .201 special. Race number 9 to the line. Okay, we got to have Women's Ski Limited and Junior 1315 Limited. Women's Ski Limited, Skylar Stone, Yukiko Kume, Lauren Conroy, Debbie Hyde, Corey Zabala, BB Carmouche, Angie Carlton, Meg Conroy, and Teo Bomer. Let's get you down here to the line. But on the water right now, Brandy Raidmaker, the 15 of Ron Henderson out of Temecula, California, the 226 of Dawn Fiquette, KMG Racing, Mystic Lou, Bomber Eyewear, Impro's Dasa, RRP Commander, and Performance Fiberglass out of Lake Havasu City, Arizona. But here comes the bomber to put another lap on the books as Tommy Bonacci out of Costa Mesa, California on the Yamaha Bomber Eyewear, KMG Racing, IPD Graphics, Quakey Sense, and Maxima Oil Special. Your leader, second place, the 99, Hunter Dunn. Huntington Beach, California, Raceline Wheels, IPD Graphics, Twisted Tin, High Speed Industries, and Mom and Dad, oh, special, Jet Trim. I can't make it up, the father just said. He's milking his parents for all they got. That's good for Hunter. Good for him. But we're happy to have him on the water. Brandy Raidmaker out of Henderson, Nevada. High Speed Industries, Rava Motorsports, Jet Pilot, Jet Lift, Nelson Sweets. I got to know what Nelson Sweets are because I know there's some inside joke. Tommy Bonacci coming around, putting another lap on it. As the 99 of Hunter Dunn in second spot. Third is the 44 of Chris Versola, Santa Barbara, California. Fourth, the 111 of Annie Sims out of Lake Elsinore, KMG Racing, Pyro Images, Mystic Lube, HydroTurf, Bomber, Jet Tribe, C57, and Jet Renew. And then here comes the rest of the pack as they come around to fill in. So the pack's really split up. So Brandy Raidmaker will lead them around, followed by the 15 of Ron Henderson, Tommy Bonacci, and then the 226 of Dawn Fiquette. So Tommy puts another lap on the books as he's weaving his way through lap traffic. And here's your second spot, the 99, Hunter Dunn. In the third spot, coming around right now, that's Christopher Sola. So white flag, here comes the checkered for the bomber. As he comes around, Tommy the Bomber Bonacci will take the checkered flag. Coming right in for inspection. Hunter Dunn coming around.
Yes.
As they come around, Brandy, oh, hanging off the side.
the 15, Ron Henderson, almost came off, was able to put it back up. So when
Mangan,
Jonathan, come on in real quick.
I think it's that's fine.
All right, so everybody but the juniors goes on the band. Everyone but the juniors go on the band. Juniors will go on the flag. Juniors will go on the flag.
We'll throw that in and take the other one out. So which one?
So this is a combination for race 9, Women's Ski Limited and our juniors. So the 177, BB Carmouche, your leader, the 69, Yukiko Kume, in the second spot, the 72 of Lauren Conroy. That's your top three.
As they run out on the track right now, Carmouche with the lead in Women's Ski Limited with Yukiko Kume in second, Lauren Conroy in third. So the top three are all the Women's Ski Limited class racers. Looks like the number 12 going to slide into fourth, which is first overall in his class. That's Theo Balmer. Looks like maybe the 72 of Conroy having some issues out there, so she momentarily goes down in the tray, so that's going to put the 12 of Balmer in third overall in the track, but first in his class. So the 913 of Meg Conroy coming around now in the women's limited class. Skylar Stone looks like she's holding down third in the women's limited. Top two out on the track, encountering some lack traffic, so Carmouche still able to hold off Yukiko Kume. Those are your leaders out on the track right now. Third place on the track, first in his class, is the 12 with Theo Balmer. Halfway flags are coming out. Three laps down, three more laps to go. So coming across now in second in the juniors class, looks like Reese Maricich. The 245 Angie Carlton coming around in the women's class as well. Her first race ever. That's great for her. Home run out there. It's great to see more girls, too. We got to see more girls on the line, so we had a good girls class today. Definitely like to see that. So your top four out on the track, still the same position, no change in the running order. Skylar Stone coming across, still holding down a solid third place in the women's ski limited class. Meg Conroy coming across, now in fourth. Got a couple lap riders to encounter as Bibi Carmouche comes around taking the white flag. So the 245, Angie Carlton, her first race ever. Awesome to see some new talent in the women's class out there, holding her own. All right, as the white flag comes up for Skylar Stone and Meg Conroy having a great battle for third and fourth in the women's limited class. Bibi Carmouche coming across, taking the checkered flag, taking the overall win for the day in women's ski limited. Yukiko Kume coming across in second. So that'll be your top two girls as Theo Baumer takes first in the juniors class. Juniors 13-15 limited as we wait for Reese Maricich to come around. He should lock down second. So as he comes around now, your second place runner in your juniors 13-15 limited will be Reese Maricich. And we're waiting for our third place women's ski rider right now as she runs, Skylar Stone. So if she can hold on to her position, Skylar Stone locking down that third place in the women's ski limited class. Meg Conroy putting on that last minute charge, but I just don't think she's going to have enough to catch Skylar Stone. So Skylar Stone going to come across third. Great riding out there by these juniors and these ladies today. All right, race number 10, Amateur Ski Mod. Amateur Ski Mod is on the line now on the number one. Out of Lake Havasu City, Arizona, that's Andrew Gowicki. He's on a four-stroke powered bullet racing hull with a Sea-Doo Spark engine in it. So that's something new we see out here today. So give props to those guys for trying something new, showing off the four-stroke machine. On the number 10, out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Mateo Juarez. On the 13, out of Peoria, Arizona, that's going to be Blake Wickland. On the 45, out of Corona, California, Daniel Yonan. On the 111, out of Farmers Branch, Texas, Flying Bryant Smith. And on the 202, out of Lake Havasu City, Arizona, Cole Kramer. This will be Amateur Ski Mod. Wayne Guy to the starting line. There you are. All right, we're getting them whipped up here. Amateur ski mod. Looks like a clean start once again. Looks like the 10, Mateo Juarez, going to come away with a hole shot. With once again Cole Kramer on that 220 in hot pursuit. So again, Juarez out to the outside, Kramer to the inside. Blake Wickland again in tow as well. So the top three mimicking what they did this morning in Moto 1. Kramer able to slam the door as they drag race down the straightaway. Juarez going to try to take him wide, but Kramer slams the door shut. Able to hold the lead. So give it up for Cole Kramer, able to steal the hole shot away from Mateo Juarez once again in this amateur ski mod. Kramer's already got it wicked up, heading down the back straightaway as the afternoon wind is starting to chop up the race course out here. So we'll have to see which way these riders decide to go and use the split instead of advantage. And as I say that, Juarez catches an edge. So Wicklin's going to go to the inside. We'll see if he can make up any ground. This one's going to be close as they come around the straightaway. Wicklin able to steal second place away from Mateo Juarez. See if he can make it stick. He does. So that was their run. Now, put Wickland into second behind Cole Kramer. Cole Kramer continues to lead with Blake Wickland in second, Mateo Juarez in third, as we have a rider down on the right-hand side of the track, Andrew Gawicki on that four-stroke powered bullet racing machine. Flags are out for Cole Kramer and Blake Wickland as they come around first and second. Mateo Juarez still walking down that third place in this amateur ski mod. So Cole Kramer coming around as your leader, taking the white flag, trying to put a lap on the 45 of Daniel Yonan, and he does that. Wicklin coming around, taking the white flag in second. And as we wait for our third place running Mateo Juarez, the 111 of Flying Brian Smith coming by now. Here comes the 10 of Mateo. So once again, a great ride by Cole Kramer, putting in a dominating performance in that amateur mod class. On the line now, race number 12, which is junior ski, 10 to 12 stock. So this is the future of our sport. 10 to 12 year old kids, boys and girls, well represented in this class out here today. So on the number 92 out of Flagstaff, Arizona, that's Logan Gasparone. On the 100 out of Gilbert, Arizona, that's Revan Harris. On the 299 out of Lake Havasu, it's Julian Balmer. On the 365 out of Lake Havasu City, Stevie Bascom. On the 600 out of Roland Heights, California, Mo Canamori. And on the 831 out of Livermore, California, that's Talon, the Ace Chambers. Chief starter Paul Stone got the two card in the air, ready to drop the band for these juniors. Looks like a clean and green start this time. So we'll see who's going to come away with it. A great battle going into the first turn between three riders at this point. This time it looks like Julian going to come away with the whole shot preliminarily coming around the outside. Looks like Revan Harris going to the inside. Talon Chambers chasing down Julian. So he's going to come around with a drag race right now with Revan Harris as they come across the front straightaway side by side. So Chambers trying to do it the hard way, trying to sweep the outside, not able to make the move just yet. So Revan Harris moves into second. Talon Chambers in third. Looks like fourth is Mo Canamori. So girl power represented here really well in the juniors class as well. So Mo Canamori and then Stevie Bascom. So we got the two girls battling it out as well out there. So Julian coming across with the lead right now. They call him Juju, so he's doing a great job locking down that lead in this junior ski 10 to 12 stock. Revan Harris in second with a hard charging. Talon Chambers once again using the inside split to his advantage, trying to make a move. So he's within one boat length right now of Harris, just not quite able to make a move yet. So we'll have to keep our eye on those two as they're rounding the right-hand side of the track. All right, race 12, where are you guys? You guys should be lined up on the line. That's Sports Spec. I don't see any takers right now. Sports Spec should be on the line to keep things moving smooth here. Get things going in way. Sports Spec to the line. Next up would be Vintage X2 Open on deck. So Vintage X2 Open, you're on deck. So right now, no change in the top three. Balmer, Revan Harris, and Talon Chambers rounding out the top three. Canamori still in fourth with our other girl rider, Stevie Bascom, close behind her. right. White flag is in the air one more time around for Juju. So Juju holding his own. Revan Harris locking down that second position. Talon Chambers still hanging on to third. Got a great battle between the two girls right now going down the back straightaway as Moi Kanamori is able to hold off at this point in time Stevie Bascom, but Stevie Bascom starting to put on a charge. So with one more lap to go, we'll have to see what happens here as they come around the split. So Kanamori taking the white flag in front of Stevie Bascom, who's still putting the pressure on. And checkered flag should be coming out. So Balmer is going to take the win. Revan Harris coming across second. Talon Chambers third. We have a rider down on the left-hand split. Thank you. The 92 of Gasparone taking a little water sample. Looks like he's okay, back to his ski, so. As we wait for the final riders to come around, Mo Kanamori battling with Stevie Bascom. She's gonna go to the inside. Kanamori to the outside. We'll see what happens here as we've got a course marshal in the way as well, so Kanamori throttles it up. Gonna make the turn. They drag race across the start finish line. Kanamori just able to nip the third place from Stevie Bascom. But what a ride for those girls in that junior ski 10 and 12 stock. The future of our sport is strong. If this is any indication of the riders up and coming. All right, on the line right now, race number 13, Sports Spec. Sports Spec is on the line right now. We've got on the number 9, Brent Disney out of Washington, Utah. On the 10, out of Chino, California, Tony Martinez. On the number 99, out of Huntington Beach, California, Hunter Dunn. And on the 168, Bad Betty out of Surprise, Arizona, that's Nanette Sanchez. Race number 14. Race number 14, Vintage X2 Open on deck. Race 14, Vintage X2 Open on deck. Looks like taking the early hole shot, the bomber, Tommy Bonacci, slamming the door shut on that blaster. Looks like Martinez right now going to follow him into second. So it is Bonacci with a hole shot. Martinez settles into second with Nanette Sanchez in third. Hunter Dunn coming across in fourth. Brent Disney. Fifth. So Bonacci, your leader, making his way around the left-hand side of the track with Martinez in tow, separated by about two buoys. opened it up just a little bit on your third place rider. That's Nanette Sanchez. So Bad Betty locking down third right now. As she settles into third, the 99 of Hunter Dunn coming by in fourth. And now Brett Disney starting to put a little bit of pressure on Hunter Dunn, so we'll see if he can make up any ground in this sports spec class. So Vintage X2 Open, you guys should be lining up now. Vintage X2 Open, you guys should be lining up now. Am Ski Lights on deck. All right, white flag coming out for your leader, Tommy the Bomber Bonacci, locking down that first place. The number 10, Tony Martinez, still holding on a second. Bad Betty, Nanette Sanchez, still hanging on to third. So with one more lap to go, we'll see if she can continue to hang on to her third place running out position out there today. Hunter Dunn, though, keeping the pressure on, so keeping her honest is Hunter Dunn. Disney following suit as well, so those three keeping each other honest out there with one more lap to go. So your winner, Moto2, Tommy the Bomber Bonacci. The number 10 of Tony Martinez is going to be second. And as we wait to see if she can hang on for a couple more buoys, with Hunter Dunn still putting the pressure on, Bad Betty, Nanette Sanchez, one more turn to go, and she will hang on for that third place finishing position. Thank you. Coming up next on the line, Vintage X2 Open. Vintage X2 Open on the number 51. That'll be Jackson Rod. On number 25, Derek Stout out of San Marcos, California. The 67, Lori Ortega out of Chula Vista, California. The 109, Charlie Sims out of Lake Elsinore, California. And on the 121, your Moto 1 winner, that's Danny Ortega. It looks like taking the whole shot one more time. Your Moto 1 winner is out front in Moto 2. That's the 121 of Danny Ortega. The 109 of Charlie Sims, again, trying to track him down. The 25 of Derek Stout. The 51 of Jackson Rod. And battling again with Lori Ortega. So we got a husband and wife team out there as well in this class. The Vintage X2 Open. So Ortega showing some speed now with his Vintage X2 Open machine. Turning up the wick, going down the back straight. He's really got that X2 looking good, hooked up quite well. And he was your Moto 1 winner. So if he can hang on, he'll take the overall here today. Coming up next, race 15 will be Amateur Ski Lights. Am Ski Lights, they're on the line now. Race 16, Master Ski Stock, you're on deck. So Master Ski Stock, race 16, you're on deck. Race 15 is on the line now, that's Amateur Ski Lights. Coming to us on number 13 out of Peoria, Arizona, going to be Blake Wicklin. On the 22 out of Lake Havasu City, Guy Vinatieri. On the 40 out of Goodyear, Arizona, J.J. Stone. On the 72 out of Tucson, Arizona, that's Ryan Decker. On the 111, flying Brian Smith out of Farmers Branch, Texas. The 202 out of Lake Havasu, Cole Kramer. The 213 out of Washington, Utah, via Brazil, that's David Prado. On the 400 out of Lake Havasu, Bob Hyde. And on the 626 out of Flagstaff, Matt Legerski. That'll round out your Amateur Ski Lights class. Race number 15 coming up next. As we continue to watch the Vintage X2 open, Danny Ortega continues to lead over Charlie Sims and Derek Stout. So no change in the running order, top four. So Jackson Rod still walking down that fourth place with Lori Ortega chasing him down. So white flag is in the air, one more lap around for our Vintage X2 Open as Danny Ortega continues to lead over Charlie Sims and Derek Stout. That's your top three. Lori Ortega was able to make a move around Jackson Rod once again, so that'll put Lori Ortega into fourth. Jackson Rod top five. Checkered flags in the air, so your winner overall for the day in Vintage X2 Open, that's going to be Danny Ortega. Great ride by Danny today. Second place, Charlie Sims. Third place, going to be Derek Stout. And if she can hang on for a couple more turns, looks like Lori Ortega, the husband and wife team out there today. Lori Ortega going to lock down that fourth place with Jackson Rod rounding out the top five. So coming up next, once again, Ski Amateur Lights, great stacked field of talent out here in the Am Lights class. A couple of the young guns have been turning up the heat today. So we'll see if they continue to tear up the track like they've been doing. Of course, talking about Blake Wickland, our winner in Moto 1, and Cole Kramer, two of our young guns of the sport, really showing some speed out there. J.J. Stone locked down third in the first moto after not racing for a year. So it's great to see that family out here again as well. Of course, we've got David Prado in here from Brazil. So got riders from all over the place being represented here in this amateur ski lights class. Got a full gate. Gonna go six laps. side. Looks like we had the ski towed in and getting things ready to go here. So getting the course cleaned up after that last race of Vintage X2 Open. So on the line now, Amateur Ski Lights, Moto 2. It's for the overall. Clean start by our young guns, both of them getting a great start. Wicklund and Kramer drag racing again in the first turn, side by side, bar to bar. As they make the turn, Kramer going to squeak to the outside, so that forces Wicklund to the inside. We're going to see who's going to come away with it. Looks like Wicklund caught a slight edge there, so that's going to cost him just a little bit. Kramer able to take the whole shot. Actually, J.J. Stone putting the pressure on now on Wicklund, so they drag race for second and third. Wicklund slamming the door on J.J. Stone, but J.J. Stone having the inside line going to the next turn. So he'll settle into third once again. Looks like David Prado once again into fourth. All right, as they come around, Cole Kramer's going to be your leader. J.J. Stone slides into second place as Blake Wicklund having some problems momentarily shut the boat off. He's going to be fourth now as J.J. Stone and David Prado are battling now, put David into second. So great move by Davey to take second. J.J. Stone third, Blake Wicklund back to fourth. So now Cole Kramer is able to open up his lead. Smooth sailing now for Kramer as he continues to run the outside split the smoother way around in this late afternoon chop. So Kramer now your leader comfortably as Davey comes around now in second. Straight away behind, J.J. Stone able to lock down third. Wicklund settling into fourth. With the 22 now of Guy Vinatieri in your top five. So your top five riders all within a couple buoys of each other. See Brian Smith coming by in the 111. The 916. So your top three continue to run in the same running order. J.J. Stone right now holding off Blake Wicklund and the 22 of Guy Vinatieri. So that is your top five. So Kramer is making his way around the left-hand side of the track, about to encounter some lap traffic. So the white flag coming out for Cole Kramer as he's making his way through some lap riders on the right-hand side of the track. Davy Prado from Brazil still locking down second. J.J. Stone still hanging on to third. Blake Wiglin fourth. And Guy Vinatieri still hanging on to fifth. So if they can make it around one more time, no change in the running order, that will be your finishing position. So that's going to shake up the overall. We'll have to check the scoring because I believe Wiglin was the winner in Moto 1 with Kramer being second. So that'll probably give Kramer the overall. Not quite sure. J.J. Stone may settle in the second overall or David Prado. So we'll have to see how things are going to finish up here this afternoon in this amateur ski lights Moto 2. So Cole Kramer going to come across, taking the checkered flag. Your winner in amateur ski lights, Cole Kramer. David Prado from Brazil come across second as the 111 lap rider Brian Smith coming by. And Blake Wiglin looks like he was able to slip into third, so I'm not quite sure what happened to J.J. Stone as the 22 of Guy Vinatieri coming by fourth. So J.J. Stone coming across top five. So again, that'll shake up the finishing order and the overall points for amateur ski lights. So coming up next, Masters Ski Stock Moto 2. Masters Ski Stock on the C88 out of Fort McMurray, Alberta, Canada. That's going to be Jerry Wong. On the 55 out of Lake Havasu, Charles Anderson. On the 111, Rusty Wilson, transplanted to Scottsdale, Arizona now. On the 226, Don Fiquette out of Lake Havasu. And on the 621 out of Colorado Springs, going to be Glenn Powell. All right, we're getting them fired up now. Master Ski Stock, Moto 2. Clean start by all the riders. Looks like preliminary hole shot going to go to Jerry Wong. The battle's for second between Charles Anderson and Rusty Wilson. Looks like Wilson was able to slam the door once again on Charles Anderson, but Wilson goes down momentarily, as does Anderson. So Anderson able to navigate around and not miss that yellow buoy. So once again, our top two as they repeated Moto 1. Jerry Wong coming across as your leader. Second place, Rusty Wilson. Your third place rider is going to be Charles Anderson. And Don Fiquette right now locking down fourth, but the 225 of Glenn Powell starting to put the pressure on. So Don Fiquette closes the door on him and makes her way around the double reds on the right-hand side of the track. So great to see Don having a great ride out there today in both motos. Coming up next, we need the runabouts. The runabouts, runabout amateur rec lights, runabout naturally aspirated. You guys should be on the line next. Runabout amateur rec lights and runabout naturally aspirated to the line, please. All right, halfway flags are out, so halfway down, halfway to go here in this Master Ski Stock Moto 2. So as they run, mimicking our Moto 1 finishing positions, Jerry Wong, your leader, with Rusty Wilson still in tow on the 111. Charles Anderson still running third, and again, putting on a great ride today, Don Fiquette. She's got fourth place lockdown, so if they continue the way that they're running now, that way now, they will be your overall finishing positions for the day. So checkered flag in the air, your winner overall today in Masters Ski Stock going to be Jerry Wong. And coming in second, the 111, that's Rusty Wilson. So that's your top two in the Masters Ski Stock class. And as we wait for them to come around, I believe Charles Anderson will lock down third. And Don Fiquette will lock down fourth. So coming up next, we've got on the line our combined classes scored separately. Runabout Amateur Rec Lights and Runabout Naturally Aspirated. So on the AmRec Lights, on the number one, that's Justin Black out of Irvine, California. He's in the Amateur Rec Lights class. And in the Runabout Naturally Aspirated, on the number eight, that's Eric Graff out of Mesa, Arizona. On the 188, your winner Moto 1, that's Tony Beck out of Lake Havasu. On the 222, James Alamillo from Palmdale, California. The 282 out of Indio, California, Jonathan Rivera. The 422 out of Lake Havasu, Cody Jones. And on the 771, the ageless Bill Wilson. Coming to us from Palm Springs, California. Jackson Rod, Jackson Rod, are you within striking distance? We need to get you on the course martial boat. Jackson Rod, are you close by to get on the course martial boat? So looking like the leader right now in your runabout naturally aspirated to 222, that's James Alamillo. He's locking down that first place position. Looks like he's holding off Tony Beck. Tony Beck was our winner in Moto 1, and Alamillo was second. So if they flip-flop, that'll actually give Alamillo the winner overall for the day. Third place is 422 of Cody Jones, so he's duplicating his finish from Moto 1. And coming across in fourth is 771 of the ageless Bill Wilson. So he's locking down the same position he was in. And then coming across now in the runabout amateur rec lights, our one and only on the number one, Justin Black. All right, coming up next is Novice Ski Limited. Novice Ski Limited coming up next on the number 10 out of Las Vegas. That's Trisha Juarez. On the number 69 out of Phoenix, Arizona, going to be Jonathan Mangan. On the number 71 out of Edgewood, New Mexico, Jesse Dernberger. On the 72, Lauren Conroy out of Cave Creek, Arizona. On the number 91 out of Flagstaff, J.B. Gasparone. On the 213, once again from Brazil, David Prado. On the 365 out of Lake Havasu, Dwayne Bascom. On the 626 out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, Nathan Lopez. And on the number 997 out of Las Vegas, going to be Doug Romer. This will be Novice Ski Limited coming up next. So out on the track, halfway flags are out for Jim Alamillo. So he continues to lead in the runabout naturally aspirated class with Tony Beck running second. Flag is in the air. The white flag's in the air now. So Tony Beck coming by. .422 coming by now, catching the white flag in this runabout NA. Bill Wilson coming around. And the checkered flag is in the air. The .222 going to take the overall win for the day. That's Jim Alamillo. So able to take the win on his so-called vintage old school XP Limited, able to hold his own against the new four-stroke Yamaha-powered ski that Tony Beck is making his way around the track now on the left-hand side on. So if he's able to make it around the last turn, that'll put Tony Beck in second overall for the day. And making his way around now on the right-hand side of the track as well, the 422. Locking down that third place overall. Bill Wilson coming around now. He's going to finish in the top five. So coming up next on the line, we have Novice Ski Limited, full gate once again. Novice Ski Limited. Got a couple young guns in this class as well, some seasoned riders. So we'll see if the battle continues as it did in Moto 1. David Prado from Brazil was able to take the win in Moto 1. Two cards in the air, we're getting fired up here. A little bit of a crazy start there. I didn't quite see a few people hold their lines, but looks like everybody was able to make it through without a crash. So green flags in the air. So coming around right now with the preliminary hole shot on the outside is Jonathan Mangan, but he's drag racing with the 213 of David Prado, your winner in Moto 1. Prado slamming the door on Megan, so Prado going to steal the lead. Looks like Conroy now slipping into second. So Lauren Conroy making a great move on Megan, slipped into second. Just as I say that, they both go down. So now that's going to put JB Gasparone into second. So a big shakeup on the first lap, as we also have a rider down on the left-hand side of the track that looks like Doug Romer. So we've got riders down on both ends of the track now. Looks like everybody's okay, up and running again, but big shakeup on lap number one. So locking down the lead now as he comes around on the inside split is David Prado. So if he can hang on, he'll take the overall today at Novice Ski Limited. JB Gasparone is your new second place running rider with a 71 of Jesse Dernberger now moving into third. The 365 coming around in fourth, that's Dwayne Bascom. Settling into fifth place now, that's Lauren Conroy after the little get-off she had with Trisha Juarez in tow. So David Prado coming around one more time as your leader. Still no change in the running order of the top three as JB Gasparone is coming around in second. The 71 locking down that third position, Jesse Dernberger. Wind continues to get stronger here this afternoon. It's really chopping up the water conditions. So as we start closing in on the final moles of the day, water's getting rougher and rougher. We've got white caps out there on the back straightaway. So these riders really having to give it their all to stay upright and keep these skis hooked up and driving through this choppy water in the late afternoon here in Parker, Arizona. So things have kind of settled down now, and our top three have stabilized. No change in the running order. As we have a rider down one more time on the right-hand side of the track, course marshal's there to attend to him. So looks like he's okay getting back to his ski as David Prado continues to lead with J.B. Gasparone continuing to run second. The 71 of Jesse Dernberger running third. Conroy coming around in fourth now. So 626 coming by, Nathan Lopez with the number 10, Trisha Juarez in tow once again. 365 coming by, Dwayne Bascom. So white flag coming out for Prado one more time around. Coming around to take the checkered flag, your overall winner for the day in the Novice Ski Limited class, all the way from Brazil, David Prado taking the win. And if he can stay upright one more time around, the 91 going to come in second, J.B. Gasparone. And rounding out the top three should be the 71 of Jesse Dernberger. All right, coming up next, Runabout Pro-Am GP, the big, fast runabouts. Moto 2 of the Runabout Amateur GP. On the number 9 from Buena Park, California, is going to be Charlie Martinez. On the number 67 out of Corona, California, is going to be Brandon Warner. And on the number 680 coming to us out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Eric Senko. Thank you. right, taking the hole shot in this runabout Pro-Am GP class. This time out front, Brandon Warner on the two-stroke XP Limited. Able to steal the hole shot away from Charlie Martinez. So if they flip-flop their running order right now, that'll give Brandon Warner the overall for the day. So we'll see if he can hang on as he runs out front now. Running third, Eric Senko. So that'll give him third overall for the day. Warner's got that beautiful XP Limited wicked up by Mel Miller Power Plant flying out there. Novice runabout stock, you guys should be coming up to the line next. Novice runabout stock, we need you guys on the line. And then our final race of the day, on deck, Master Ski Mod and Pro-Am Ski Mod. All right, so out here one more time around. Warner locking down the lead right now over Charlie Martinez. So if things remain the way they are as the halfway flags are out, Warner's going to end up with the overall for the day. Two laps to go as they come around one more time in this GP runabout. So Warner continues to lead over Charlie Martinez and Eric Senko. Coming up next will be novice runabout stock. Be Pete Harris on the Yamaha to Gilbert, Arizona. Kelly Church out of Lake Havasu. And Owen Adams out of Apache Junction. right, checkered flag coming out. So Warner able to take the win. The overall for the day in the runabout GP class with Charlie Martinez locking down second. And we wait for Eric Cinco to come across in third. So that'll conclude a runabout GP. On the line next, novice runabout stock. You guys should be on the line. Novice runabout stock. And our final race of the day, Master Ski Mod and Pro-Am Ski Mod, you're up next. The final race of the day. We're missing a ski on the line. If you want to make your moto, you better hurry up. Pete Harris, you're supposed to be on the line. Novice runabout stock, you should be on the line. Pete Harris. All right, he's coming, guys. So on deck, our final race of the day. Master Ski Mod and Pro-Am Ski Mod, you guys will be up next. Go and they're off. Novice runabout stock. So Kelly Church looks like he's going to come away with a hole shot one more time. Got that Sea-Doo dialed in. He's out of Lake Havasu. Locking down second, going to be Owen Adams. Rounding out your top three in your final spot. Pete Harris, so if they continue to run in this order, that'll be your overall finishing position for the day in novice runabout stock. As Kelly Church was your winner in Moto 1, and he's out front now in Moto 2. They come around, still no change in the top three running order of our novice runabout stock class. Kelly Church continues to lead over Owen Adams and Pete Harris. Just about halfway through as we get set for our final race of the day of round number three of the Jettribe Best in the West Watercraft Racing Series. That's going to be Master Ski Mod and Pro-Am Ski Mod. So in Master Ski Mod on the number 37 out of Lake Havasu is going to be Tony Beck. On the number 62 out of Flagstaff, Arizona, going to be Matt Ligurski. On the 66, coming to us from Japan, Yuji Shiroki. On the 525 out of Cake Creek, Arizona, is going to be Mark Conroy. And on the 400, Rob Hyde. And in your Pro-Am Ski Mod class, coming to us from Lake Havasu, on the number 17, that's Tara Lejo, the Terrorizer. On the number 72 out of Tucson, Arizona, Ryan Decker. On the 177 out of New River, Arizona, B.B. Carmouche. And on the 212, your Moto 1 winner out of Fort McMurray, Alberta, Canada, Mike the Clipper, Klippenstein. So, halfway flags are out for Kelly Church. He continues to lead on his Sea-Doo in this runabout stock class. With Owen Adams locking down that second place position. Pete Harris locking down third. So once again, if they finish in the order that they're in now, that will be for the overall positions for the day. Duplicating what they finished earlier in the day in Moto 1. The white flag in the air for Kelly Church, leading this one wire to wire, as he did in Moto 1 of this novice runabout stock class. Owen Adams coming around now in second. Pete Harris able to close the gap just a little bit on Owen Adams, but I don't think, unless Adams makes a mistake, he'll have just enough time to get by him. So as we wait for them to make their way around the right-hand side of the track, Kelly Church making his way onto the outside split one more time around. Couple more turns to go. And your winner, wire to wire, Moto 1 and Moto 2, taking the overall win is Kelly Church. Novice runabout stock winner today. So locking down second is going to be the 33 machine of Owen Adams. Coming rounding out the top three is Pete Harris. That brings us to the final race of the day of round number three of the Jettribe Best of the West Racing Series. Combined class scored separately Master Ski Mod and Pro-Am Ski Mod. Going to go seven laps to round out the day here.
we're back. Had a little battery on the mic die. Right at the last moto of the day. Imagine that.
All right, as we shake out that first crazy lap in this final race of the day with the Master Ski Mod and the Pro-Am Ski Mod, Mike Klippenstein, your overall leader, mimicking what he did in Moto 1, but the new second place in the Pro-Am Ski Mod class, the 72 of Ryan Decker, the 62 of Matt Ligursky is your leader in the Vets Masters Mod class with the 525 in second, Mark Conroy. Coming around in second is Terralejo, in third in the Pro-Am Ski Mod class. Tony Beck coming by now in Masters as well. That wild first lap really shook up the running order, so Clipper, if he can hang on, will be your overall winner today in Pro-Am Ski Mod. The real race right now is for second. If Ryan Decker can hang on to second place, he will take second place overall for the day. So as Clipper comes by your leader, here comes Decker in second on the track and for overall in the Pro-Am Ski Mod class. As the 62 comes by, Matt Ligursky, he's your leader in the Master Ski Mod class. With Mark Conroy coming around now in second in Master Ski Mod. Then the 69 of Yuji Shiroki. So he's third in Master's Mod. Terralejo coming by now, getting around Shiroki. She is third in Pro-Am Ski Mod. So right now, Ryan Decker actually is keeping the pressure on Klippenstein, so Clipper continues to lead, but Decker right now ready to steal second place overall from Terralejo if he can continue to run where he's at. Matt Ligursky right now is holding the lead for the overall for the day in the Master Ski Mod class as he got around Mark Conroy, so that will give Conroy second overall for the day in Master Ski Mod. Flags out. So no change in your top five in either class as we run. So Terralejo has got that bullet racing open GP ski wicked up, trying to see if she can reel in Ryan Decker, if she has enough time to regain that second place finishing position for the day. So as she runs right now, she would be third. But she's trying to track down Decker, who's making his way around the left-hand side of the track as Lejo gets onto the back straightaway. So we'll see if she has enough time to try to make a move and close the gap. White flag coming out for Klippenstein. So only one more lap does she have to be able to track down Ryan Decker, although she's closed the gap within to two turns now on Decker. Matt Ligursky continuing to lead in the Master Ski Mod class. So Mark Conroy going to come around second once again in Master Ski Mod with Yuji Shiroki hot on his heels in third. Coming across, taking the checkered flag, and the overall win for the day in Pro-Am Ski Mod is going to be the clipper, Mike Clevenstein. Stealing second place today is going to be Ryan Decker. Matt Ligurski going to take the overall win in Masters Mod. Terry Leho going to come across in third in Pro-Am Ski Mod. As we wait for Mark Conroy to make his way around in Masters Ski Mod, he will be second. BB Carmouche coming around now. She will be fourth in Pro-Am Ski Mod. And Yuji Shiroki is going to round out your top three in Masters Ski Mod. So now we're waiting for the last two riders to come around. Looks like it's going to be Tony Beck. So Tony Beck will finish in fourth. So he makes it around. So Tony Beck going to take fourth in Masters Ski Mod. And on the 400 machine, Rob Hyde will round out the finishing order. And this will conclude the racing for today and round number three of the Jettribe West Coast Racing Series. Thank you.
Great day of racing. Great day of racing. Round number three in the books for the Jettribe Best of the West Series. As we move on to tomorrow, round number four. Once again, remember, if you need to add or scratch classes, you may do so tomorrow morning between 7:30 and 8. Between 7:30 and 8 a.m. Riders meeting will be at 8. It will be a very quick riders meeting. We plan on being on the water at 8:30 in the morning. 8:30. I will do a roll call, so if you're not here at 8 o'clock and you're not in at the riders meeting, you may be fine. So don't miss it. 8 o'clock riders meeting. 8:30, we're going to start. We're going to snap our first band before 9 o'clock. We are rolling in the morning. And here are the words that you've been waiting for me to say all day. You are free to move about the cabin. You are free to move about the cabin. So everybody enjoy safe. And we'll... All right, and I have a Visa card for a Daniel C. Hicks. Daniel C. Hicks. Come see Ross Wallach. Daniel C. Hicks, come see Ross Wallach. Right now.
I think you could kind of use that. Well, I just jumped with 2 seconds. Oh, okay. There you go. We don't let anything get by us.
All right, so we want to thank everybody that raced today. Our thoughts and prayers are with Mike Hable, and we'll see everybody tomorrow morning.
Who's alarm?
It is definitely.
No, I don't need to. All I need to say is something about that they need to have a couple for today because they can't contest tomorrow, so they need to wait till their scores are posted and check.
Wait till your scores are posted, come down and check, and if there's any questions, you got to ask today. So, pit board will be up and posted very shortly. Once today expires, don't ask about it tomorrow. Not even you, Flying Brian.
I didn't hear it.
Also, if you have any radios, any of the radios, please turn them in so we can get them charged and get them back to you tomorrow. Any staff that has any radios, let's bring them to Ross so we can charge them up and get them back to you. Paul Pistone, we still need you. I need you down here right now, please. Paul Pistone, we have a question to discuss. All right, we need the Carltons, Jason Carlton, up to scoring inside the River's Edge Cantina. Jason Carlton, up to the scoring at the River's Edge Cantina, please. See the girls.
Robbie, what do we have left? Is everything out? If everything's out, then I'll go